Hey guys, Scott here from Scott's Bass Lessons again. Today I'm going to be showing you a right hand exercise, or plucking hand exercise, so if you're left handed it will be your left hand, I don't want to discriminate. So a plucking hand exercise, and it's basically to help you with your string crossing, or string skipping should I say, so missing out a string. When you're playing, for instance, the E to the D string, it can be problematic having the A string in the way, so this exercise is going to utilise this movement and really get it happening in your playing. On the left hand, or the right hand if you're left handed, or the neck hand, all I want you to play is octaves, okay? And the pattern is, it's really easy, okay? Starts on the F, okay? Just F, then down a string, B flat, then the octave, okay? So once more, F, octave, B flat, octave, and then with your little finger move up a fret, B, the octave, F sharp, octave, and then up again, G, C, D flat, A flat, A, C, okay? So that was just one note per string. Now we're going to do two notes per string. I should say this as well, really, this should be automatic, this hand. It's really easy, okay? Just octaves moving up. This hand is what you should be really, really looking at. You should be looking at each individual movement. Are you playing it as efficiently as you could do? I did a tutorial on raking and alternate picking, okay? So make sure which one you decided. Did you decide to go alternate picking? Did you decide to start with the raking, okay? If you did make that decision, and you did watch that tutorial, if you didn't watch the tutorial, go watch it. If you did make a decision, you know, alternate or raking, make sure you're utilizing that here as well, okay? It's gonna be tough. So two notes per string, okay? Sorting your muting out as well on your right hand. That's to the C again, a bit faster. And then you can go back down. Was two notes per string, now three notes, okay? Now this is going to completely change the feel, because now you're playing triplets, okay? So you're playing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So the key is to drive the speed up, you know, get that speed happening. I'd get a metronome on just so you can take note of what speed you can do it cleanly. Doing it cleanly is so important, okay? Don't be, you know what I mean? It's got to be ba 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 ba. You know, the notes have got to be clean, okay? Be truthful with yourself. If it doesn't sound good, slow it down. Okay, them now fours, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Be even with the speed in the tone. Metronome, see how fast you can take it before your notes start becoming unclean. So maybe try what did it, but exercise for today, so get that into your practice regime. Really concentrate on what your right hand is doing. That's the key to this exercise. It's nothing to do with this hand really. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, do so, and then every time I release a video, you'll get it in your inbox, in your email. So hopefully you've enjoyed this exercise, and until next time, get in the shed and I'll see you soon. Take it easy.